In this presentation, we are going to continue the topic about the set-based tests for rare variants in large-scale biobanks and cohorts. Besides the need to account for unbalanced case control ratio for binary phenotypes in biobanks, we will go through several additional challenges of set-based tests for identifying associations of rare variants in large-scale cohorts and biobanks. We will talk about using scalable mixed models to account for sample relatedness in the data, which has been implemented as an extension of the SAIGE framework called SAIGE-GENE. Recall that we have introduced the SAIGE method for GWAS on a single variant association in large-scale biobanks and cohorts, which uses saddlepoint approximation to account for unbalanced case control ratios, accounts for sample relatedness based on the logistic mix model for binary phenotypes, and adapts optimization strategies to make it work for large-scale data. However, single variant association tests by GWAS are usually underpowered for very rare variants, and set-based tests can be used to increase the power, in which rare variants are grouped and tested together based on some functional units, such as genes. In the previous presentation, Zhang Chen has talked about accounting for unbalanced case control ratio of binary traits in a set-based rare variant association tests using the saddlepoint approximation and efficient resampling. Next, let's look at accounting for sample relatedness using mixed models in the set-based rare variant association tests. EmmaX-SKAT is a mixed model method for gene-based tests that has been implemented in the SKAT-R package. Phenotype is regressed on genotypes with random effect B to account for sample relatedness. The variance-covariance matrix of B is corresponding to the N by N genetic relationship matrix, where N is the number of samples in the study. Gene-based test statistics can be constructed based on the score statistics from the marginal model for individual genetic variants in the tested gene or variant set. Here we're showing the test statistics for the burden test and SKAT test. SKAT-O test is a hybrid of burden and SKAT. This is similar to what Zhang Chen has introduced based on the linear regression with unrelated samples. Similar to the single variant association tests for binary phenotypes with related samples, for set-based rare variance tests for binary phenotypes, logistic mix model can be used. SMMAT is a logistic mix model method for set-based rare variant tests for binary phenotypes. Both EmmaX-SKAT and SMMAT have heavy computation burden. The bottleneck for the computation cost is computing the p-hat matrix, which requires the inversion of the GRM for each gene or variant set. The computation time for this step increases cubically as sample size increases, plus storing the n by n GRM costs much memory when the sample size is large. It will take EmmaX-SKAT 11 CPU years and about 1 terabyte of memory to conduct genome-wide region-based tests for one phenotype in a UK Biobank. To solve the computation cost issue of the mixed model methods for large-scale data, we can use the same optimization strategies as in the previously developed scalable mixed model methods for GWAS of single variant association tests, such as both LMM and SAGE. We try to solve the four main challenges and develop the method called SAIGE-GENE, which is an extension of the GWAS method SAIGE for conducting set-based association tests for rare variants in biobanks and cohorts. We have implemented the burden, SKAT, and SKAT-O tests in SAIGE-GENE. SAIGE-GENE was co-developed by Zhang Chen Zhao, who gave the previous lecture on rare variant association tests. And it was led by Dr. Sheng Li, who currently works at Seoul National University in Korea, and with collaboration from University of Michigan, Broad Institute, and the Norway University of Science and Technology. Benchmarking was performed on randomly subsampled UK Biobank data to conduct exome-wide gene-based tests for one phenotype. We have evaluated the computation time as shown on the right and the memory usage as shown on the left for SAIGE-GENE and other methods. As we can see that SAIGE-GENE is feasible for conducting set-based tests for the UK Biobank data sizes, while other methods such as SMMAT and EmmaX-SKAT cannot handle sample sizes larger than 20,000. Here, the computation cost of step one in SAIGE and SAIGE-GENE is close to linear to the number of markers used for computing the genetic relationship matrix on the fly. So that's why we have two lines for SAIGE-GENE on the in the plots, and one is using 93,000 genetic markers to construct GRM, and the other one is using more markers, 340,000 markers to construct GRM. Similar to SAIGE, SAIGE-GENE contains two steps. In the first step, the non-linear or logistic mixed model was fit with phenotype covariates and genotypes that are used to construct the GRM on the fly as input. In step two, set-based tests are conducted for each variant set. There is one extra step compared to single variant association tests. In step zero, here is the step zero, we need to estimate a sparse version of the original GRM. We call it sparse GRM. The small values in a full GRM are set to zero in a sparse GRM. The step zero to create a sparse GRM is only required once for each data set, and the sparse GRM can be reused for different phenotypes. Note that we still use the full GRM to fit the null model in step one. The sparse GRM is mainly used after step one and before step two to estimate this ratio of variance of score test statistics with the full GRM and with the sparse GRM. So in step two, instead of calculating the variance using a full GRM for each gene or variant set, which is quite time consuming, we can use the sparse GRM and this pre-estimated ratio to approximate the variance with the full GRM. This is actually another approach that further reduces the step two computation time. Next are simulation studies to evaluate SAIGE-GENE. We see p-values from SAIGE-GENE and SMMAT are consistent for all burden, SCAT, and SCAT-O tests. We observe that under the normal approximation, which we call unadjusted set-based test here, as expected, inflation was seen for binary phenotypes with unbalanced case control ratios for the set-based rare variant association test. After applying the saddlepoint approximation and efficient resampling in a robust method, the type 1 errors have been well controlled. We have applied SAIGE-GENE to quantitative traits for exome-wide association tests in two biobanks. One is the Hunt study from Norway with heavy sample relatedness, as figure A shows, and the other one is the UK Biobank, as figure B shows. As expected, we have identified several well-known genes for these traits. We have also applied SAIGE-GENE to binary traits for exome-wide association tests in the UK Biobank. Here's the QQ plot for glaucoma as an example. The top gene is MYOC, which is a gene well known to be associated with the risk of glaucoma. SAIGE-GENE has been implemented in the SAIGE-R package, and the summary statistic for the UK Biobank jobs can be downloaded in the second link. Note that all analysis in this presentation in the UK Biobanks is using the imputed data. More recently, UK Biobank released their whole exome sequencing data, which contain more rare variants. and we're currently analyzing the datasets using SAIGE-GENE.